power. That is the blunt message that is being delivered in clear, crystal clear terms from a fired up Joe Biden to a Fox News reporter who was asking him about the debunked conspiracy theory that is being pushed by the president that involves Biden, Biden's son, and Ukraine. Biden just took the stage moments ago in Iowa. Let's listen.
Yeah, that's right, Alex. Earlier today, he did talk to the media about these unfounded claims about him and his son. There is no evidence to these claims, and he had a lot to say about it. Take a listen.
Mr. Vice President, how many times have you ever spoken to your son about his overseas business dealings?
I've never spoken to my son about his overseas business dealings.
And so how do you know?
Here's what I know. I know Trump deserves to be investigated. He is violating every basic norm of a president. You should be asking him the question.
The third problem is that it's not at all clear that getting rid of this prosecutor would have helped Biden at all.
Number two. No one has said my son has done anything wrong, and I did not on any occasion. And no one has ever said it. Not one
thing you were doing anything wrong.
I set up my son to work in an oil company. Isn't that what you said? Get your words straight, Jack.
There's a photo of you golfing with your son, Hunter, and his business partner, Devin Archer. Do you stand by your statement that you did not discuss any of your son's overseas business?
Yes, I stand by that statement.
My son's statement speaks for itself. I did my job. I never discussed a single thing with my son about anything having to do with Ukraine. No one has indicated I have. We've always kept everything separate. Even when my son was the Attorney General of the state of Delaware, we never discussed anything. So there'd be no potential conflict.
Hunter says he and his dad only spoke once about Ukraine. Dad said, I hope you know what you're doing. And I said, I do.
It's a fact.
Well, you have raised an issue. Let the Vice President answer.
Discredited.
Did Burisma pay him $183,000 a month with no experience and energy?
Mr. President,
my son did nothing wrong at Burisma.
I think he did.
Mr. President, let him answer.
He doesn't want to let me answer because he knows I have the truth.
Welcome, everyone. I wanted to quickly get this video out because this news is just breaking. Now, we're going to get right to all this breaking news, but first, just give me 30 seconds for a quick capitalism break from this episode's sponsor, Noble Gold.
If you worked for a company for years before COVID came around and you were let go, you might have left some treasure behind. Your old 401k or IRA could be worth thousands, and it's still working for your old firm. Not you. So if you're a bit uncertain about what the future holds right now, you should call the team at Noble Gold at 1-877-646-5347. And if that's not incentive enough, with each qualifying IRA, you'll get a solid silver 5-ounce Apollo 11 coin free. So it's worth jumping on the phone and calling 877-646-5347 now. That's 877-646-5347.
Leaked emails seem to prove that Joe Biden was lying when he claimed to have not discussed his son's Ukrainian business dealings. Okay, so this is not completely new. Joe Biden has denied that for a while, and his son actually busted him out on that during an interview where he accidentally admitted that he had spoken to his father about that. It didn't seem to matter much. And then there was actually pictures leaked not long after that that showed Joe Biden and his son and one of these executives. It may have been the same executive. So not only in this case did Joe Biden talk about his son's business dealings with him. No, it went much further than that. He actually met with a top executive. He actually met with this executive. And before that meeting, there was an email exchanges between Hunter Biden and this executive. According to the New York Post, quote, the never-before-revealed meeting is mentioned in a message of appreciation that an advisor to the board of Burisma allegedly sent Hunter Biden on April 17, 2015, about a year after Hunter joined the Burisma board, at a reported salary of up to $50,000 a month. Now, that's one of the things that people saw and kind of raised red flags about this whole thing is, why is this guy that has no experience in the energy sector, why is he getting with this company, this Ukrainian energy company that's paying him so exorbitantly, $50,000 a month, a lot of money, why would they pay him that money? What is he bringing that company? Well, obviously, he's the son of the vice president. So one of these emails in question reads, quote, Dear Hunter, thank you for inviting me to D.C. and giving me an opportunity to meet your father and spend some good time together. So it gets worse if you can imagine that. An earlier email from May of 2014 shows an email correspondence where this number three executive is actually asking Hunter for advice on how his influence could be used on the company's behalf. And in this email, they're actually discussing the fact that the company may be coming under investigation. In this email, the executive says, quote, "We urgently need your advice on how we could use your influence to convey a message, signal, to stop what we consider to be politically motivated actions." Hunter responded by asking if there was any more information about these accusations being made against Burisma.
So they said they were walking out to press conference. I said, we're not going to give you the $1 billion. They said, "You have no authority. You're not the president." The president said, I said, "Call him." I said, "I'm telling you, you're not getting $1 billion. I said, "You're not getting the billion. I'm going to be leaving here." And I think it was, 6 hours? I looked, I said, "I'm leaving in 6 hours. If the prosecutor's not fired, you're not getting the money." Well, son of a bitch. Got fired.
These emails prove that a meeting occurred between the executive and Joe Biden just months before the vice president pressured the Ukrainian president and the prime minister into getting rid of that prosecutor who was investigating his son's company. And we all know how that went, with Joe Biden basically threatening to withhold $1 billion of a U.S. Loan guarantee during his December trip to Kiev. We've all seen that video. And in fact, it was actually announced that Hunter had been added to that Ukrainian energy board on the exact same day that he and that executive had that email exchange about possible investigations into the company. Now, like I said, Hunter has contradicted his father before on this during other interviews, and it didn't really seem to matter. I mean, we even got these pictures of him from 2014 with these Ukrainian energy company executives and his son. The question is, will they be able to ignore this again? I think it's going to be hard. I mean, this is about as smoking gun as you can get. Maybe they'll just claim the emails are fake or something along those lines. And we'll get into how these emails were procured. But another reason I don't think they're going to be able to ignore this is another part of this treasure trove leak of these emails are videos of Hunter Biden engaged in, let's say, smoking crack and banging. They might be able to ignore everything else, but the tabloids and the memes and everything else are definitely going to pick up that story. So it's going to be impossible to ignore, and people will probably find out about the rest of this in the course of reading about that news. Now, get this. All these emails came from a MacBook, a secondhand MacBook that had been taken into a computer shop for repair. According to the New York Post, the customer who had brought in the water-damaged MacBook Pro for repair never paid for the service or retrieved it or the hard drive. According to the shop owner, who said he tried repeatedly to contact the client. Now, let me just say from firsthand experience, I've worked in the IT field for decades, and for several years, I worked at a little IT shop, and the same thing happened there pretty regularly. People would bring in laptops for repair. The repair cost more than the laptop was worth, and they would just leave it. Crazy stuff. I cannot wait to see what pans out from all of this, but I would say don't get your hopes up. I mean, this could be very damaging to Biden, but no doubt that the media will do its best to control that damage. That's all for this episode. Please hit that like button, share, and subscribe. Thanks for watching. See you next time.